Cyber attacks on hospitals seem to be on the rise. Is medical IoT security to blame? Stick around. Hey everyone, welcome back to Today in Tech. I'm Juliet Beauchamp. I'm here with Network World writer Jon Gold. And today we're going to be focusing about medical IoT and security. So Jon, first of all, thank you so much for joining us. My first question for you is, we think a lot about telehealth, at least I certainly do, is that I'm calling my doctor, I'm on FaceTime with my doctor, I'm on Zoom with my doctor. Could you tell me a little bit about how telehealth and IoT devices are more interlinked than one might think at first glance?
Yeah, because I think the simplest answer to that is that that's not totally what telehealth is anymore. Telehealth also encompasses a lot of, you know, connected devices, thermometers, just any kind of, measurement or monitoring device that, would be in your home, but is, sending telemetry remotely back to a doctor or a healthcare provider.
So could you tell me a little bit more about what some of these IoT devices are? I know a lot of us are perhaps using telehealth a lot more often to check in with our doctors, on account of a chronic health condition. And I'm wondering how IoT devices tie into telehealth in that way.
It's a matter of, it's a matter of obviously your condition. But what it mostly centers on is monitoring. You might have, a device that will send data remotely to your physician. If you have diabetes, they can maybe monitor blood sugar levels. Thermometers, just with, particularly important in the age of COVID. Any kind of monitoring device, and, these are frequently being, from hospitals and being used, in the home as a response to, the need for a lot more home care. The sort of the array of devices that, are out there for, they probably fall under the umbrella of telehealth, being used in home medical IoT is expanding really fast.
So I'm wondering a little bit what the goal perhaps of a hacker would be. So it seems to be maybe hacks on hospital systems through an IoT device are maybe happening more often, maybe they're not. It seems to be sort of a mixed answer there, depending on who you ask. But what's the, ultimate goal of a hacker in this situation?
Well, the malicious hacker in this situation is out for what malicious hackers in, most situations like this are. They're out for money. The prevalent technique, at least the end goal they're trying to get to is to infect, a major healthcare provider's network with ransomware. So, this will, as you probably know, will encrypt everything on the network and, require this organization to pay up, in a given amount of Bitcoin if they want, to get access to their systems again. And what makes the healthcare sector such a tempting target is, tragically the fact that, not infrequently will simply have to pay up because, this is a matter of patient safety. These systems will need to be online at all times. So cyber criminals know that.
So I'm wondering now if there's any specific examples that you can point to of attackers, hackers exploiting coronavirus, COVID-19 for their gain in this situation, whether it's through gaining entry through an IoT device or phishing. I have to imagine that phishing ransomware is really their go-to method.
Yeah, phishing doesn't really have anything specifically to do with the IoT aspect of it, but it's, definitely the end goal of, a ransomware infection remains the same. The IoT angle is more about, the idea that a poorly secured device can be used to, gain as sort of an access point onto the network. If all your traditional IT, your computers, your servers, your networking equipment is all, reasonably well secured, you might have this, something as simple as, again, some kind of patient monitoring device that isn't quite, configured correctly, and that provides, a way onto the network for a bad actor.
So I guess the crux of what I'm getting at and what I'm curious about is why now? I know, like I've mentioned, and like you mentioned in your article that we'll link below, is, maybe these types of attacks are on the rise because of COVID-19. Maybe they aren't. But let's, take the position of some of your sources that said, yes, they are. Why are they happening more often now?
I think it's mostly a part of you know, if in fact you, like, as you mentioned, these sources do sort of split. I've had people tell me that it's not a reaction to COVID. It is a reaction to COVID. It's unclear. If you do take that, take the tack that yes, it's, you know, these attacks are increasing as a response to COVID. It's about, you know, the fact that there are more devices, you know, and more potentially vulnerable devices on any given medical network right now, just because there's, you know, so much of this, you know, fast growing need for remote healthcare. And, you know, the fact that the time frame is such that they don't have a lot of time to, you know, maybe go through and secure these systems as well as they might.
So I'm curious then, what's sort of the other side of that coin? What are people's arguments that are saying, no, this isn't COVID specific?
I think the argument that it's not COVID specific is largely that you can't prove it is. And that's hard to argue with, frankly. You know, it's not, there isn't anything, you know, it's hard to point to any particular thing out there and say, you know, says, yep, they're after, you know, COVID patients or something. I think that, and I say that's perfectly fair. It's just more, you know, it's just not necessarily COVID specific, but I think the argument would be more that it's about responding to, you know, any expansion in the use of connected devices, you know, for healthcare, you know, whether it's COVID or not, you know, the technology is progressing anyway. You know, you have this usage spike that's pretty clearly tied to COVID, but, you know, it's not necessarily about that from the perspective of malicious hackers.
Sure, that's a great point. I mean, it doesn't really matter what necessarily the catalyst is, but anytime that there's this huge swath of IoT devices pushed onto a network, and like you've mentioned, that they're potentially very attractive targets because they're also many times, I mean, I've heard you say multiple times that, you know, medical IoT devices, they're not made by IT professionals, they're made by a medical device company, so they may not be created with that, you know, security first mindset. That makes a lot of sense that it doesn't just have to be COVID, it would be any sort of event in which a lot of IoT devices were, you know, suddenly pushed on or pushed out to users.
Yeah, absolutely. These are companies that sometimes have pretty thin margins. You know, cost control is a big concern, and sometimes, regrettably, security is the thing that gets left behind.
So, Jon, before I let you go, I'm going to ask you what I'm sure feels like the million-dollar question, which is, you know, what's the answer? How are you supposed to secure these devices? You know, if you're a CIO in a major hospital system, what should you be thinking of? What should your first consideration be when you learn, okay, we're now going to have to be using a lot of telehealth services? How can we stay the most secure?
Well, there's no clear silver bullet or anything for this. You know, you're constrained by the fact that the devices themselves can be pretty tough to secure, you know, at that level, but a couple of helpful techniques are that, and this goes for all sorts of IoT, is you need to have good visibility into exactly what is on your network, because a lot of these threats, you know, come about because, you know, the people who are managing the network themselves don't have a clear picture of exactly what's there. So it's hard to, you know, identify what traffic is normal, what traffic might not be. So network visibility is a huge deal. And network segmentation too, you know, creating different, you know, sort of logical network segments for, you know, which that could be creating a divide between, say, you know, your IT, which will have patient data and, you know, control and the control plane on it and everything, and, you know, the operational devices, which, so this means, you know, if somebody can get into one of these poorly secured devices, it still might not necessarily give them access to, you know, everything else on the network.
Great. Well, thank you so much, Jon. I really appreciate you calling in and chatting with me.
Thanks for having me.
And thank you all so much for watching this episode of Today in Tech. If you liked this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. If you have any questions, comments about medical IoT security, please let me know in the comments below and we'll get back to you. And once again, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.